Our life is like a game, like a snakes and ladders game. Please raise your hands if you have played snakes and ladders in your life. Great, the whole room. So, we all know that the players, we rise. With snakes, we fall down. Similarly in life, sometimes we rise, sometimes we fall down. How do we react every time we rise? My heart goes sha-la-la-la-la, sha-la-la-la-la. How do we react every time we fall down? Ouch! I just hit it! I don't want to do it again! We react in different ways. We react in beautiful ways, beating those Khans and Kapoors. But do we heal? Heal, because every time we fall, the voices of those snakes, the voices of those falls, those hisses, tries to tell us something. So, heed to those hisses. Heed, learn lessons, and bounce back, just like this ball, and keep moving on with your life. Good afternoon, dear Toastmasters and guests.
Good afternoon.
Thanks to Facebook, I got in touch with a remarkable lady who heeded to those hisses. She was the 23-year-old national volleyball player back then. She boarded the train with lots of dreams and aspirations. Suddenly, at 1 a.m., a gang of thieves entered the train. They tried to snatch her gold chain. She resisted. She was overpowered and thrown out of the moving train. She lay there between two railway tracks. Her hands were wounded. Her spine was fractured. And her left leg was ran over by another train which passed by. She lay there, shivering in extreme cold and crying with extreme pain and fear. After 7 hours, help arrived. She was rushed to the hospital, but she had to lose her left leg. Her left leg was amputated. Life took a complete turn and Arunima was shattered. Everyone thought that was the end of her sporting career. Everyone thought, will she ever bounce back in life? But she proved them wrong. She bounced back and achieved something really big. She bounced back and did something which even the able body feared to do. Yes, just 2 years after that awful incident, she stood on the top of the world. She stood on the top of the Mount Everest and created history. She became the first female amputee in the world to do so. She was so inspiring, isn't it? One day, I asked Arunima, Arunima, no fall is bigger than losing one's own legs. But how do you bounce back? Arunima replied, Megla, I just hear to those hisses. When I was in the hospital bed, the voices of those falls told me, Arunima, get up, bounce back, and encourage people who are crushed like you, who are thrown away like you, who are ripped apart like you. Get up and inspire everyone. Get up and tell them, even you have better tomorrows. Arunima said, I heeded to those pieces and achieved in life. I was really moved by her reply and started heeding to those pieces. Why don't we also heed to those pieces? Because every fall, every setback, every failure, every sickness tries to tell us something. Toastmasters, is your body failing to work? It means get up, start exercising, and stop treating your body like a waste bin. If your relationship with someone tries to fail, tries to fall apart, it just says, get up, spend more time with the person, give more to the person than you receive from the person, or take up your coffee day and sort the problems out, just like our Sakti Prakash does. Toastmasters, did you fail in a Toastmaster contest? It just says, get up, bounce back. Even the world champions did not make it easy. Sweat more. The people who made it to the top did not make it easy. Every failure, no matter whether it is small or big, always tries to teach us something. So, heed to those pieces. Dear Toastmasters and guests, have you noticed a child is trying to walk? She walks for 2 steps, falls down. Next day, she walks for 4 steps, falls down. Finally, she masters the art of walking, and nothing can stop a child from walking. Life is making the child to fall so that he or she can walk 1,000 miles later. Did you fall down today? Are you struggling to walk today? Life is making you fall so that you gain enough strength, you gain enough maturity to face the beautiful things which are lined up for you. So, be grateful to those rises. Be doubly grateful to those falls, because they fall tries to tell you something. Toastmaster, did you heed to those pieces today? Over to you.